All right, so in this video, let's tackle a very common problem that people have. So basically, we have sales recorded in this table, and every salesperson that we have is in this one table. So we want to create some reports, but as we create our reports, we want to make sure that each salesperson can only see their own data without being able to see other people's data. Now, you might be thinking, now we need to create a bunch of spreadsheets and do import ranges and make sure that we only get the data from one person and then based on that build reports. But what if I told you that we can do this with a single report using Google Data Studio? So to be able to do that, we need to first add a column to our data. And the way we're gonna do that, first let's just replace one of these reps. I'm gonna take Olivia and I'm gonna just call it this guy. So that would be me in this case. So I'll do match entire cell contents and just replace all. So there it is. So then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add another tab. I'm gonna call it salespeople. And what I'll do here, I'll get a nice clean list of salespeople from here. So I'm gonna go here and do equals unique. Go to new data and select this data right here, drop the end reference, close parentheses, hit enter, and that's our list. I don't want this to be a formula. I'm just gonna copy and paste as values only, and that would be sales reps name. So what I'm gonna do in this next column, I'm gonna add their emails, and that email would be the email they use as their Google account. So let's just make something up. And this would be my email to be able to test this. So now at this point, what I need to do, I need to make sure I have this column over here in my data. So I'm gonna create another column. I'm gonna call it email. And I'll just do a VLOOKUP to just transfer those names over here. So I'll just look up these and in this table, F4. Comma 2, comma 0 for exact match. And this should allow me to just copy those names over to the other tab. Now this only worked for the first one because I didn't do Control Shift Enter or Command Shift Enter. It's not an array formula yet. But before I do that, I also want to just add an if statement here. And I'm gonna say if this range of data equals blank, then let's just leave it blank. Otherwise, let's just use that lookup, just like that. Close parentheses, Control Shift Enter or Command Shift Enter to get array formula around this and hit enter to just apply this formula. So now if I just do command down, see, we have all of these emails. So this is the column we're gonna need to make this happen. And those emails again have to match the right account. So once I got all of this done, now I'm gonna go to Data Studio. So that would be datastudio.google.com. That should get you to the right spot. I'm gonna just create a blank report. And the first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna connect this to Google Sheets. And in this screen, you're gonna have to find the spreadsheet. So this is my spreadsheet name right here. This is that particular spreadsheet. So I'm gonna click on that. And if you remember, I had that new data, which was my original data. And then I made the salespeople, which was that supporting lookup table. We don't need that supporting lookup table. It was just to bring over those emails. I'm just gonna click on this first one right here and click add. And add to report. So right now, this is just going to bring over the entire data set, and it gives me counts for each region, as you can see. Now, we want to make sure that this only filters to the right person. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go back to this data source and click Edit here. And right here, there is this option, Filter by Email. I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And here, I'm going to click on this Filter Data by Viewer Email. And we're going to choose that column we've created in our dataset as the field, which I named Email. So now because we chose that, as a user of this report, I need to grant access. So I'm going to click Allow. And if I'm done now, this report should be only filtered to that person. So let's just do a different report here. So this report that it created, it seems to be a table report. So I'm going to click on this. We're going to go here and we're going to add some dimensions to this. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on Add Dimension. And we'll just add some of those columns that we used to look at. I guess I'll start with date. Drag it up as the first column. I'm going to just keep adding some more columns. We definitely want that sales rep, I guess, so we can see that this actually works. And as you can see, the only ones I'm getting here is the one that says this guy, because we filtered to that particular user. And I'm just going to continue with this and add a couple of other fields. Under metrics, I'll go ahead and add sales and probably cost of goods sold. And I'm going to move this up and remove this record count. There we go. Now we can just resize this columns, make them the way we like them. We can redesign this thing to make it look different. See, this one is doing 100 rows per page. We can do more, we can do less. It would probably be also nice to sort this by this date column to have the latest one on top. So I'm just going to scroll down and do sort. And instead of cost of goods sold, we're going to do by date and descending. Latest on top, and it keeps going down. And you could play around with this as much as you like. But if I just wanted to display the data for that person, this would pretty much be that. I will change a couple of things with design. I'll go to style. And for the header background, I'm going to choose a different color. Actually, let's go lighter on that. And let's choose a different border color here. You can also color code to have different grid lines like this if you wanted to. This is completely up to you. And this is our font color for our headers. I think I'm going to remove these row numbers on the left. Again, these are completely optional things. So one other thing I would like to do, in case you have blanks, you probably want them to show as blanks instead of null. So you can change this instead of null to be a blank. And that should be a regular table. So at this point, if we just view this report, see, this would show just the data for that person. We would probably want to just resize these columns to make them nicer. We probably also don't need this sales rep column anymore because that just filters to that particular rep, technically. But if you wanted to keep that, obviously you can. So I'm going to click view. There it is. So now I have the report for just me. And if somebody else logs in to the same report, it's going to filter to their email. And therefore, it's going to be just their records. So any other report we add to this will still use the same filter. So if I go back to edit, if I want, let's say, a summary for our salesperson, right? Well, I could do it on the same page, but I think I'm going to just add another page here, add a page. What I'm going to do, I'm going to just do some sort of, let's say, pivot table. Put it in here. And again, that's going to link to that same data source, which is, again, just filtered to this person. So now I can just build my report. So for my metric, I'm going to go ahead and add, let's say, sales amounts. Record count would not be bad too. As you can see, it tells this guy right here on top, and that's because I have column as a dimension here. I don't really need that sales rep as a dimension because we just have one, but if you wanted to keep that, you could, obviously. This breaks it down by region for that data. So if I just go back to that page one, this is pretty much that data we're working with. So at this point, we can decide how we want to slice and dice this. Maybe we want to report by date, or maybe you want to report by category. I don't know, whatever it might be. I'm going to go back to this. What I'm going to do in this case, I'm probably just going to have date as a dimension. And I'm going to change that a little bit. I'm going to click on this edit, go back to this date, and go under this date and time, and maybe we'll do something like year month sort of thing. And I'm just going to say month here, I guess, or you can say year month, just a column name for this. And I probably would like the latest ones on top. I don't want to sort this by record count. I want to sort it by date. And that would be, see, this is the first dimension here. This is the second thing I did in rows because I still kept here region in rows and year here. So we might want to keep that or maybe not. I'll come back to that. But for now, I'm going to scroll down. And for the second one, I'm going to go to the sorting. And instead of record count, we're going to sort it by year month. And we're going to make sure that's descending right there. So one way to represent this a little better, I guess, would be to maybe take the region and pull it below year month. So it breaks it down by region for each year and month. And that should show that report. Our sales amounts are here. We probably want to represent them in some sort of dollar amounts. So I'll click on edit on the sum, go to type, and choose currency for this. There it is. Again, you can restyle this, do background colors, whatever. It's still under here, under styles. I guess one thing I'm going to change is the size of this text here. Let's make it a little bigger. You might want this region here as a breakdown, or you might also possibly want to just add it as a filter instead. That might be better. But the main point here is that I can build my report, and this report would be filtered to just that person. So if I go under view, let me zoom out a little bit, and there it is. Now I have page one, which gives me this data, which is our more granular data right here for that person. I can go to page two. I have my summarized report. This doesn't seem to be sorted anymore. I thought I did sort it, but maybe after I moved things around, that sort order broke. So let's just take a look. See right here, now year month is the first one. So let's just switch this to year month descending. So then latest should show up first. And you could add your slicers, filters, dicers, whatever else you need to do. So I can add a control and add a drop-down list here. And here I could choose actually region and remove the region from here possibly to make this a little nicer. So then I can filter by region if I wanted to, but I don't want to see that region breakdown here. So let's just take a look what this looks like. If I go under view, see we have region. Now we can pick whichever region we like. That will filter our report. Just like that. And we could add another dropdown maybe for category or something like that. We allow more flexibility on this. Another dropdown. And for this one, I'm going to choose control field to be category. And here we can just go ahead and click view and you'll see I should be able to now filter by category as well. So if I wanted to maybe look at certain type of dresses, I should be able to do that. So let's say we want to look at formal dresses. wedding dresses and some night out dresses or something like that. And finally, we'll just edit this, rename this. Again, if you want to learn more about Data Studio and how to manipulate these things, I have videos covering Data Studio, but this would be our sales rep report. And we could just share this one report for everybody, and everybody would see their own data. And that should be it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.